gonna be totally awesome. So hooray, watch and be great.
Woo!
Yeah. Woo!
Well, everyone can see you well. Yeah. You can feel free to sit down if you like, whichever you want.
This portion of tonight's program is brought to you by 100% Comes in Three Quarters by One. Casting over to those I've parted, small beam of light, hoping to find. Kicking through your reply. Oh, it is foolish to think no one is busy. Just as foolish to think no one has time. Maybe it's because my hands have been so empty, and my daddy still has yet to write me back. My employers haven't called me in some weeks, and the people I love most are awful quiet, so I don't speak. Reaching out means more folks to not hear from, and I am frightened. I get so scared. I paste myself into the web, but you won't see me there.
Wow, the light went. Some light went off. Set with like me and my trembling guitar thing was like December, just this last December in Brighton, Massachusetts, and I just got into the part in Spud that's like, am I boring you? I'm probably boring you. When from the corner of my eye I see these two figures get up and slowly leave the room, and I thought, or I paused rather to say bye Tim, bye Chris, because I knew who they were, and I knew they had to catch a train to Rhode Island. But it didn't help me from thinking, shit, am I boring people? Because I've certainly lost interest, and that's been like the general feeling every time I have to, or the last several times I've had to play a set with just me. Because at the end of the day, 100% is a healing project. I'm sure either you've experienced this or you know people do this where use art as a channel for catharsis. It's like taking something that consumes you and transforming it into something else that you can work alongside as opposed to underneath. But that whole process, because it's so personal, it just becomes a little like masturbatory. I feel like I've become too proud and selfish and like frightened to hand my work over to other people so we can present something that's like sonically complete, whatever that means. And I think now you don't have to compromise one for the other, I just haven't prepared that yet. So I decided, why not share something that I feel is more complete to me.
Can I have a volunteer, please?
Maybe like one other person?
I won't pick you out.
It's not like real stand-up.
Can you come forward a little bit?
before I go to sleep. And shit, they make sure you go to the toilet, pull down your trousers and your pants.
Fine,
it's important, okay? Don't just...
Are you blocking you? Do you want to be part of it?
Oh my god, that's
right. And if you're enjoying being alive,
wow, this is the nicest thing I've ever met.
Breathe with your mouth or nose. Breathe out.
February 14th. There's something to celebrate. Wow, look at all these smartphones. Hi, Internet. February 14th. If you don't know what to celebrate, now you know, because birth of an important domain name, YouTube.com. 2005. It's been 11 years. Tomorrow, I guess. Wait, photo app. Okay. Quality control is something that I learned of last winter when I had to sling chocolates. What you had to do is you had to taste certain chocolates and macarons to make sure that they were in good condition to sell and in good condition to eat. So you had to make sure that the salts weren't weeping and that the macarons weren't frozen. And I think I don't do that enough with myself or with my friends or with the scene. The scene. And yeah, this is something I'm thinking about a lot. What does it mean, self-care at the expense of whose labor? Or like, you know, like, fuck bath bombs. That's all I gotta say. And, but also, like, to what extent do you have responsibility over making your friends happy and making sure that they're okay? Or like keeping a community, keeping an arts community in a community. And so, you know, actually, this is, hello. I'm trying to go viral tonight, so you made it. I think we can put this down, one, because I think we understand that this whole time it's like been a conversation, right? Thank you. It's, you know, I'm not like talking to a camera, to a screen, and that's what it's like with vloggers. I have a secret. Maybe we don't know enough about each other, but what you need to know is I love YouTube. And then 2007, 2011, I was obsessed. This is like my first foray into arts community. And I was particularly interested in like UK vloggers and all that. Just by a show of hands, anybody here is or has ever been a YouTuber?
Yeah.
Sorta.
Yeah, what'd you do? It's okay if you did ukulele covers in the bathroom.
I just post videos of shows I go to. Does that count?
Sure, yeah, if you have an account.
Yeah, there we go.
You made videos? Whoa, can I ask you?
Strictly covers of Avril Lavigne songs.
Oh my gosh. Wow. Fun fact, I covered Neutral Milk Hotel in high school. You were a YouTuber.
Yeah,
what'd you do? Oh my god, like reviews?
Yeah.
Unboxing?
You guys remember Bakugan? Those things? Yeah. I guess I move them around, I got 250,000 hits. Oh, it's great.
Okay, what year? What year did you make videos?
Like 2008.
The golden age. It's not what it used to be. I know, and here's what happened. I left YouTube, so goodbye, Fred. Not watching Fred anymore. And I went to purchase, and I had my first experience like being in a non-virtual arts community. And that was awesome because it felt like, yes, I can participate by being a contributor, but I could also like by creating, but also by supporting. And leaving school and not really being close to like an art scene in my immediate community, I've been reverting. Like what people are want to do when they graduate, they watch anime and like, I don't know, reread Harry Potter and then go back to YouTube. So, but the thing is that YouTube has gone through a radical shift, just as the DIY scene has gone through a radical shift. And I've only been a part of any DIY whatever for 5 years, which is not long at all. It's not like it started when I went to college. And YouTube hasn't really been around for so long either. 11 years isn't very long. But something that I've noticed is that there's this disillusionment happening of like, yeah, it's not what it used to be. In 2012, Benjamin Cook made a documentary called Becoming YouTube, and it's about what it means to become a big contributor on YouTube, specifically in the UK. And a lot of people seem to be bitter about it, despite how short of a time YouTube has been in existence. Like, yeah, they sold out, or like once Google bought it, whatever, people are making stupid content now. And it's like, I guess it's rather different. It's like more alien than the DIY scene, but I don't know if you feel the same way, if you've got fears. Who's afraid? Who's like jaded and like upset or frustrated?
Yeah.
About what? You know, like, and like, how do you have that conversation, and who can you blame, or like, how can you fix it? How can you change it? And I suppose it's self-efficacy with anything, right? Like, what Benjamin Cook says in the documentary is, if you don't like what it means to become YouTube, how can you make YouTube become more like you? And I think the same thing goes for the scene. If you don't like what's happening, why talk shit? Just like, you know, like, I talk shit a lot, and it didn't do anything for me. I started going to shows less. I started playing shows less because I got tired and I had less money and, like, just got upset at like, things that I could... Maybe it's not all in my control, but I'd rather do something that makes me nervous, like this, which is largely improv, but a conversation nonetheless, than do something that makes me feel kind of tired.
Wait. Excuse me. What is going on here?
Ellie, everything's under control. I'm just his voice coach.
What are you doing?
I heard you were about to commit social suicide, so I thought I'd just drop by.
My confidence left.
That's brilliant. Then you don't have to do it.
Can't do that.
Yeah, you can. Just, you know, tell him artistic differences. You can't work without him. He had a drug problem. It's easy.
My mum wants me to sing it. It'll make her happy.
Look, last minute. Nothing you do can make your mum happy, right? I mean, not in the long term. She has to do that for herself.
Get over here right now.
Just bugger off, will you? What I'm saying is, the important thing is to make yourself feel happy.
Try just making myself happy. She's tried making herself happy. But it doesn't work. You need other people to make you happy.
That's just it. If other people can make you happy, then they can also make you unhappy. What, you think those people out there are going to make you happy?
These write-ups
make rent of my life with your word. Killing me softly with this scene. Killing me softly with this scene. Everyone's jaded. Remember why life was precious in this scene. And then, like, at the end of the movie, he's like, you know, I don't know why, or, you know, I don't know why Will was so upset. All I meant was, I don't think that couples are the future. You need more than that. You need backup. And the way I see it now, we both have backup. And I don't know, there are sentiments throughout the movie. Do you know what I'm talking about? Which movie I'm talking about?
Yeah. I forgot the title.
A Bad Boy?
Okay, good.
Yeah, well, okay, in the movie, like, you have, for those who aren't familiar, Hugh Grant is this guy who's a bachelor. His dad made this sick Christmas carol, died, gave him all the royalties. He lives in his pad and, like, watches TV and sleeps with women and ends up meeting this little boy, Marcus, whose mother is incredibly sad and single and suicidal. And somehow they find each other and they find that they need each other to, I don't know, just to support one another, but they both have conflicting ideas of what it means to find a source of happiness. So there's, you know, no man is an island. Well, I'm my own island, self-care, individualistic version of self-care. But then there's also, you need more people in your lives. Not just one person, but a lot of people, a network of people. And I don't really know if I'm being cohesive here, but I guess that I'm trying to throw ingredients out in terms of self-care for yourself, but also within an arts community, what it means to be happy and make sure each other, we're all happy. That's all I got. That's all I wrote. Leticia is next. Also, and quick thank you to everyone who came, everyone who walked in. Thank you to you. Thank you to you for walking in right now. And thanks to everyone who's playing. Who played, yeah.
Everybody give it up for 100%. Yay! Vagabond is next. We're going to take another friend break in which you can buy records. Oh.